Hachette Audio presents The Library of Congress Timeline of the Civil War, prefaced by James H. Billington, The Library of Congress. Introduction by Gary W. Gallagher. Read by Peter Coleman. Preface. On July 4, 1860, Americans at home and abroad sang, marched, recited the Declaration of Independence, and raised glasses to toast the 84th birthday of the United States of America, an unprecedented, if greatly flawed, democratic republic established by people determined to forge a future untainted by the tyrannies of the past. Yet only a few months after these grand celebrations, southern states, whose economies rested heavily upon the backs of 4 million people held in slavery, began seceding from the Union. By February 1861, the American experiment in representative democracy trembled on the verge of failure. 2 weeks after the artillery barrages in Charleston Harbor ignited the Civil War, the Library of Congress celebrated its 61st birthday. Then located in the U.S. Capitol, the library held 70,000 volumes and a small collection of maps that members of Congress consulted as they addressed the increasingly complex issues confronting the troubled nation. Southern legislators who had withdrawn from Congress and returned to their states still had some 276 volumes charged out to them that historic April. And Commander-in-Chief Lincoln would soon be borrowing books from the library's collections as he schooled himself in military strategy during the first years of the war. In May 1861, President Lincoln appointed a political supporter, Indiana physician John G. Stevenson, as the fifth librarian of Congress. This proved to be beneficial for many of the soldiers who garrisoned the nation's capital, for in addition to heading the small library staff, Stevenson volunteered his medical services in some of Washington's hospitals and makeshift infirmaries. In 1863, he served as a volunteer aide-de-camp during the battles of Chancellorsville and Gettysburg. Stevenson and the assistant librarian, Ainsworth Rand Spofford, who became the sixth librarian of Congress in 1864, also began acquiring material pertaining to the Civil War, a process that continues to the present day. Among the more than 145 million items that the library now holds for Congress, the nation, and the world are well over 1,000 discrete manuscript collections, including the papers of Abraham Lincoln, Angel of the Battlefield Clara Barton, abolitionist and former slave Frederick Douglass, and Confederate General Jubal A. Early, as well as letters and diaries of many less well-known soldiers and civilians on both sides. Our Civil War collections also include military maps created by both Confederate and Union topographical engineers, photographs by Matthew Brady, George Bernard, Timothy O'Sullivan, and others, original drawings made by Alfred R. Wad and other Union special artist correspondents and by soldier artists such as William McIlvaine, James Fuller Queen, and Charles Wellington Reed, sheet music written and sung during the war, envelopes decorated with Union and Confederate political messages, law books and other administrative publications of the Confederate and United States, color and black and white lithographs depicting battles, leaders, and patriotic wartime themes, political cartoons, newspapers and broadsides, dime novels, poetry, and memoirs published during the war, and thousands upon thousands of post-war memoirs and histories, including Contemplations of the War and its Reverberations, published during the 50th, 75th, and 100th anniversaries of our nation's most rending conflict. Published as the sesquicentennial commemoration of the war begins, the Library of Congress Illustrated Timeline of the Civil War includes more than 350 illustrations, as well as a rich compendium of facts and quotations drawn from this unparalleled wealth of material. Starting with the journeys that President-elect Lincoln and Davis began on February 11, 1861, departing their homes to travel to their inaugurations, and concluding with a brief survey of post-war changes and challenges, this absorbing outline of four of the most difficult years in American history reflects the complexity, anguish, stubborn determination, and valor that characterized both sides of this bitter, fratricidal war. More than a history, the illustrated timeline is also an invitation to delve more deeply into Civil War history by visiting the library, online at www.loc.gov, in person, and via the library's other print and electronic publications. To begin your investigation, See Civil War Collections in the Library of Congress on page 244 of this book. Emerging from the war terribly wounded but still very much intact, with slavery finally and forever outlawed within its borders, the United States has gone on to celebrate 146 birthdays since 1865. Each year of the country's existence brings stunning accomplishments and formidable challenges. Each challenge underlines the importance of moving into the future armed with the best possible understanding of the past. In the Library of Congress, so often and aptly called the nation's memory, history is alive and accessible in media from books to movies, from manuscripts to tweets. I hope you will accept this invitation to explore our collections. You will be amazed, moved, stimulated, and enlightened by what you will find. James H. Billington, The Librarian of Congress. Introduction. Gary W. Gallagher. The Library of Congress illustrated timeline of the Civil War draws readers into a turbulent world of violence and uncertainty. 150 years have passed since Confederate artillery at Charleston shelled the United States garrison holding Fort Sumter. The incident shocked many people, but struck others as a predictable outgrowth of sectional tensions that had been building for decades. Though bound by a common language, religion, and shared history, the white North and South had grown increasingly polarized about the expansion of slavery into federal territories and other issues related to what white Southerners referred to as the peculiar institution. Between the 1840s and the end of the 1850s, major Protestant denominations split along sectional lines, the second party system of Whigs and Democrats fractured, and a significant percentage of Northerners and white Southerners came to believe that fundamental differences divided them and that they should expect the worst from fellow citizens across the Ohio River or Mason and Dixon's line. The election of Abraham Lincoln, a Republican pledged to barring slavery from the territories, ignited passions that sent the seven states of the Deep South out of the Union within 3 months. Four Upper South states followed in the wake of Fort Sumter. The war that soon pitted residents of the incipient Confederate nation against the loyal population of the United States far surpassed in fury, duration, and consequences anything imagined by even the most prescient observers in April 1861. More than 1 million citizen soldiers became casualties, 620,000 of them dead from wounds or disease. Millions of civilians directly experienced economic, political, and social disruption. And perhaps most strikingly, within a mid-19th century context, 4 million enslaved African Americans emerged from the war as free men, women, and children. Different groups of participants subsequently developed contending memories of the war. Most white Northerners chose to highlight salvation of the Union, which preserved the work of the founding generation and safeguarded democracy in a Western world that still clung to aristocracy and monarchy. Black and white abolitionists, almost all African Americans, and a few others looked first to emancipation as a grand outcome of the war, while former rebels embraced a lost cause vision that celebrated gritty determination in the face of long odds and denied the centrality of slavery to the establishment of the Confederacy. Some people from both sides eventually adopted a tone of reconciliation, finding what they deemed American characteristics of gallantry and perseverance among white soldiers in both Union and Confederate armies. Echoes of the war and its conflicting memories remind modern Americans that hotly contested issues of the mid-19th century can still provoke passionate debates regarding race and citizenship, the relative power of central and local government, and the fate of civil liberties amid the pressures of waging war. Fashioned from a breathtaking array of written and pictorial material in the unequaled and constantly growing collections of the Library of Congress, this timeline charts the ebb and flow of events between February 1861 and May 1865. Scholars and other researchers have mined these rich veins of evidence for many decades, and it is no exaggeration to say that much of what we know about the conflict has emerged from the manuscripts, rare books, broadsides, lithographs, photographs, newspapers, government documents, maps, and other items preserved and made available by the library's superb staff. The quotations and illustrations that accompany this detailed chronological record, all selected from the library's holdings, including many items newly acquired or never before published, shed new light on this crucial period. Photographs, eyewitness sketches by artists in the field, and passages from wartime letters and diaries communicate a sense of immediacy, while post-war interpretations are implicit in artistic prints produced by Lewis Prang and Company and other firms. The contrast between wartime and post-war evidence reminds us that history and historical memory can diverge sharply. For example, Kurtz and Allison's Battle of Wilson's Creek, August 10, 1861, Union General Lyon, Confederate General McCulloch, an 1893 lithograph depicts in the heroic.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.